this is big panic for the whole world. We have this 5 billion years where we're out, where they take the scientists discovered this, or somebody has discovered this, but in 5 billion years, the planet Earth is gonna be engulfed by the sun. We're gonna drift into it and just be devoured. Okay? So we will not have any longer, we're not gonna have any more, what is the term? Life here on the Earth. None of it. It'll just turn into an inferno, a flame. So it's kind of interesting. And before that, we lose the moon. So we're going to lose the entire, all this big build, and who you are, and who they are, and what this is, and what that is, and you know, all this, these disciplines, and derogatories, and hates, and likes. Well, it's all going to be gone. It's just going to be gone into a ball of flame, and we'll die much before that, you know, I am not talking nuclear, we'll die before that with the moon being gone, you know, we'll just die, we won't survive. We have to have all of that imbalance, you know, so our time here is like a weird, we have to be in balance, or we're going to be obliterated. We're going to be obliterated anyway. It's just how long we can stay in balance, you know, hold ourselves in balance. And unfortunately, with all these nuclear things, they are not attractants to keeping that balance. They're the opposite. They're the ones that are seepers and hurters, and they take the structure of what the human race is, and they just turn us into misfits of what we were supposed to be. You know what I mean? So yeah, so we're gonna lose the Earth. We're gonna lose the Earth. I know, it's 5 billion years. It doesn't seem like a lot. Ooh, I'm starting to look a little thinner on my diet. But yeah, we're supposed to be... What is the term? Prepared? And then we're like, well, we can get into the spaceships by then, people are thinking. We'll get in the spaceships and we will go to another planet. That's the only choice. To get in the spaceships and go to another planet that is like or similar to Earth. Okay, so that's the mad race now. So they have the funding knowledge that they know we're going to implode in this time frame. And even before, because of the nuclear, well, so NASA does have, and all of these space, they do have a good rhetoric. They have a good rhetoric. They have a good plea for cash, a good want for cash. And that is going to be about selectivity, you know, who gets to go, who gets to leave. It'll just be billions of you, and you're not invited on their little spaceships out. It's just gonna be billions of you. And no, you're gonna have to stay in a swarm that is just like dying in its own insecticide. You know, you're just gonna have to stay and shrivel in it. You know, you're not gonna be invited on the ships out. So yeah, I hate to be such a doomer, but that's the human race, and that's the way it's headed. Anyway, for the now story, we really are living on paradise, but we have ruiners that are destroying paradise. You know, we could make this time now the paradise time, the utopia time, but we have the ruiners that want to ruin it now, when it's all going to be taken away in the future generations. Why? Why don't you let us have the utopia now? You know, the earth is beautiful, the plants are gorgeous, the animals are here. Why can't we have the utopia now? Why do we have to be already in the destruction phase just because we're the humans? And the want, you know, I want, I have to have, you know. Why can't we make that obligatory peace, a peaceful resolution that this is our utopia now? You know, because it's only headed into the sun. Do you understand? We're only headed into that ball inferno. It's only headed into losing the moon. It's only into nuclears imploding out. So why can't we make it a utopia now? Can't that just be our new goal in life? Anyway, back to utopia now. We have the veganism, which is a good start. It's a good help. They have great cheeses, and they have good foods that are very helpful, you know, and we don't need the factory farming. None of that has to go on. We just have regular farms that grow fruits and vegetables, and then like thusly go to the people, and nut trees, you know. It's just a simple life. A simple utopian life where we don't kill things to eat. We just are vegetarians. And when I say vegetarian, I shouldn't say that. I should say vegan. That still means capturing the cow and suckling its milk and forcing it into the purgatory of continuing to nurse during the time. During the year, you know, why should they have to nurse during the year for you to eat cheese when vegan cheese is available? It's very delicious. And a lot of recipes out there. Congratulations to those people who have made everything. Brie's and Gruyere's and gorgeous cheeses. Absolutely beautiful cheese. Wow, even blue, you can make blue cheeses out of fermented tofu. I mean, it's incredible how adaptable certain things are to make, you know, that habit that we're used to, the eating that big fat cheese steak or whatever. Well, you can have the vegan thing, a vegan cheese, and then the actual steak part, you can make that out of something else. Out of your mushrooms and your what was a good one? Mushrooms and cauliflower mixed together make a good like a taco or a steak. You can make bean burgers. You just have to squish all of that juice out of those beans. Yeah, bean burgers are real big as a help. But I mean, it's just sick anyway. The fact that you have to be clinging to that diet, and have to see a burger to survive. You know, it's just sick. It's sick that your own head is stuck, and is not willing to go past. It has to see even a vegan hot dog shape and form, you know, to feel like one of the others. I don't understand the one of the others philosophy. I mean, why? Who cares about one of the others? You know, it's just you in this life. You go through it and then you die. Who cares about the others? The others are just this generic, what is it? It's generic hype, like a generic commercial hype machine. And they're just fed it in their brain. And they're just fed it in their brain, you know, the generic hype fed in their brain. So yay. Anyway, I've been dancing Bournonville Bar this last week, and I recommend it a little bit when you're first starting out, but then I'm like, no, I put the brakes on because my thighs were going into too topsy. I'm like, so I headed back to the old Russian ABT, New York City ballet routine, which is a little bit quicker and it's a little more moving and less holding. But if you haven't been dancing for a long time, the holding way back is not bad. It's just like a good placer, you know what I mean? It places you, gets you into where your hips are supposed to be, gets you into, because some of these other styles, you know, you look at the Russians or you look at the New York City ballet and your hips are all over the place. Just, I'm here, you know, at the bar, you know. Bournonville is never that. Bournonville is just straight, square, straight and square, and no wibbles, no wobbles, nothing. I mean, it's a determined discipline. So I recommend it, like, when you're in shape, and you know your underleg muscles, and they're there, and they're really good and firm, and you can hold, I recommend it then. But I'm not recommending it if you're out of shape and you're trying to get back in, because it does to the front, what do you call it, develope a rond to the front, and that's just that heavy muscle, and it's hard to avoid it, even for me. So anyway, that's my tip with Bournonville. I love it, but I hate it. Anyway, that's all. That's all I'm telling you all, is we have 5 billion years, and we have less than that because we lose the moon before, and then less than that because the nuclears are going to just not last. Just a reminder that this is it, you know, we're looking at the beauty right now.